Welcome to my new video in the link series. In this video I will explain the let function. I have two other videos about link in my channel, that you might also find very interesting. You can find the links to this in the video description. Let's start. Let function helps us to do some calculations in the link query. I'll show you what a link query with a let function looks like. The query consists of six parts. The first and last part are brackets. Inside these brackets are the other four parts. The first part is the from statement. This statement is used to read the data from the data source. This is what the statement looks like: from, variable, preposition in, the name of the data source. The next statement, group, join, etc. Here you can insert the functions group or join, to prepare the data. The next statement, let. Here we can further prepare the data from the data source. In this statement, new variables are defined in order to do some calculations. The statement looks like this: we define a variable, then equal, then the calculation. As you can see, there is no where statement in the query, but you can insert this. This then comes before let statement. The last statement is select. After the data has been read from the data source and then prepared, it can be selected to have it as an output. At the end, after the brackets, a function is set to change the output to a certain data type, such as copy to data table, to select the output as a data table. The query is ready. Now I'm going to show you a few examples of how to implement this query in UiPath. I will start with the first example using arrays. I am creating an array variable. Create another array variable for the output. Set the default value of the variable as follows, numbers 1 to 10. Add an assign activity to write the query. In this query, I want to multiply all the numbers in the array by 2. We define a variable n for all numbers in the array. Then we create another variable a. In this variable we calculate the number n multiplied by 2. Now we select the variable a, where all numbers have been multiplied by 2. We want the output as an array, so we add the toArray function. The query is ready. Add for each activity to print the numbers in the array to the console. Change the type argument to integer. Add a write line activity. Write the following in. The code is ready and can be executed. As you can see, each number has been multiplied by 2. More than one let statement can be inserted in a query. I will change the query. We have the variable n for each number in the array. First at a, each number is multiplied by 2. After that, each number is added up to 2. I start the code again. As you can see, the numbers have been multiplied by 2, and then summed by 2. If we want to insert a condition, we can do it as follows. As already mentioned, the where statement comes before the let statement. I add the following condition. This condition is used to check whether the number modulo 2 is equal to 0. If so, the calculations below will be performed on that number, otherwise the number will not be considered at all. I start the code again. As you can see, we now have fewer numbers because of the condition. The calculations were only carried out on these numbers. The first example is done. I will show you another example about a data table. I have a table here in Excel. The table is in Sheet 1. The table consists of 4 columns: ID, name, price, count. We want to insert 2 columns using a link query. The first column should be called sum. In this column, we want to multiply the contents of the price column by the contents of the count column. The second column should be named ID underscore name. In this column, we want to merge the contents of the ID and name columns. How it all works, I will show you in UiPath in a moment. First, copy the path of the Excel file. Add a read range activity. Add the path. Clear the range to read out the entire sheet. Create a variable for the table. Create another variable for the output. Both variables are of the type data table. Add a build data table activity to create the columns of the output table. Add the following columns. You can give the names the same as they are in the Excel file, but you can also use other column names. The first 4 columns are the same as in Excel. The remaining columns are new. Add an assign activity to write the query. We want to calculate the sum column first. As already mentioned, we want to multiply the price and count columns together. This is done as follows. We take the price column and then the count column using the row variable. We want to get the content as a double, so I put CDBL in front of each column. Now we want to calculate the second column. For this I will use the string function, concat. This function merges different strings. We want to merge the ID and name columns. At the end we select the columns and variables, and insert them into the output table. We want the output as a data table, so I will add the function, copy to data table. The query is ready. In this line I inserted the columns and variables. The order is important here and must be the same as the output table in build data table activity. Add a write range activity to write the table in Excel. Add the path. Write the name of the sheet where the table should be entered. Add the output variable. Check the option Add Headers to enter the column headers in Excel. The code is ready and can be executed. As you can see, we have a new sheet. The new table is entered in this sheet. The first four columns are from the original table. The two new columns are the ones we calculated. Sum is multiplying the price and count columns. The ID underscore name column is the merging of the ID and name columns. So this example is also finished. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel to see more videos about Link.